Ladies and gentlemen, it is my absolute pleasure to welcome you back to another exciting season of Backyard Baseball 2001. We are, thus far, undefeated World Series champions, but that might be about to change because, well, we've had some pretty good teams in the past, but at this point, the only kids we haven't really used are the kind of bad ones, so if we end up seeing some new faces this season, which I'm sure we will, there might be a little bit more of the Magic Struggle Bus going on, but that's where you all get to help, because I get to pick half the characters, you guys get to help me pick half the characters, and more on that once we get the team started. Everyone grab your snacks and your popcorn, this is going to be an awesome stream, and I want to extend a special welcome out to all of you who have never seen one of these before. These are probably my favorite streams to do, they're always hilarious, and they're always a lot of fun. So for this, we gotta go to season play and start the new season. So we had the Little Monsters, and we had the Green Fishes, so now we gotta be a new coach. And this time, we'll go back to Artie, because that's my name. Aw, Artie is already in your list of coaches. You have to choose another name. What? That's not okay. R3. I like it. All right. Set up our season. So obviously we got to play on hard mode because we want a challenge. Going to keep it at 6 innings. I was debating extending it to 9 innings so that way we'd have hour and a half games, but I don't think that would be particularly interesting. I'm not including pitch locator, but I still want the swing spot. Every season I say next season I'm turning errors off, but no, we're keeping errors on because even if it makes me salty, it's always adds for some funny and memorable moments. And hey, I think that's the way Little League wants to be played. Okay, and we also need a home field. Now, we've had the home field, so first season there was no home field. Everything was on Parks Department number 2. Second season we had the Steel Stadium as our home field, which is objectively the best field. And then last season, we had the Playground Commons. I'm thinking this season, maybe Ekman Acres. It's a big field. It's harder to hit home runs on, but it does look very pretty. Yeah, let's go Ekman Acres. That was what I was leaning towards at the beginning, and it seems like that's the popular pick. Booyah. Now we get to design our team. Now, you can do one of the real-life baseball teams, but that's no fun. And also, I think that would add some unwarranted real-life sports team bias, so I like making my own custom team. Now, we've already played as the Fishes and the Monsters, so should we play as the Melonheads, the Hornets, the Wombats, or the Bombers? Bombers got retired in the league in the Discord, so you take them over? Why would they retire the Bombers? It's a great team. It's very wholesome. There's nothing more wholesome than bombs. Alright, looks like the Bombers are gonna be the team name. Oh, yes! Black and red. What? Black and red, that's actually a great color scheme. I really like that. Oh, okay. People online can be dumb sometimes. Oh, and we also need... I almost went forward. The Blue Bombers! Actually, wow, that's... I'm sure Sonic would like that one. So at this point, we've been green, we've been junior, and we've been little. I think we've kind of upgraded a little bit. So now we could be the Red Bombers, the Mighty Bombers. We're still a little green to be the super duper ones. Do people like Humongous Bombers, Crazy Bombers, or the Mighty Bombers? We are the Crazy Bombers. That's that's maybe not the best thing to be known as. Oh, Artie, you run a baseball team? What are you? Oh, we're the Crazy Bombers. You're the what? It's hard to explain, but I swear it's a wholesome team. It's Little League. Nothing says Little League baseball like being crazy and bombing people. That's for sure. Oh man, this stream's already off to a terrible start. let's just move to pick the kids. Alright. So now we get to make our team of 9. Now, there are 4 characters I have already selected in advance that we are definitely putting on our team. So first up, we obviously need the best character in the whole game, the one who stuck with me through and through, the ultimate team captain, ladies and gentlemen, the one, the only, Pete Wheeler.
I can run real good.
I know Pablo's the best character in the game, but I think Pete is the number 2. He's really, really good. He's also just been my most consistent player. So we got Pete Wheeler. We're also picking Pablo Sanchez because, well, he's the best. Hey, Mobius, welcome. Okay, and then another character we need. We obviously need Du Bois!
Ingram to play me a little bull.
I know Marky is a terrible character, but at this point, I kind of want him on all my teams. He's absolutely... He's honestly one of my favorite characters at this point. Yeah, he's terrible, but he's always very entertaining.
You sure as you won't regret picking me now.
Heck yeah. All right, now also Master Tony, everyone knows the most infamous player on my team. He's had his Star Wars trilogy, but he's fallen to the dark side, so we will not be picking Master Tony this season. We will be picking Angela Del Vecchio.
Hey, my name's Angela. Angela Del Vecchio.
Oh, are you having cake?
Tony's had his Star Wars trilogy, now Angela's getting her Star Wars trilogy.
All right. You won't be sorry, kid. I'm really good at this game, you know?
All right, so we got 3 very good players and 1 not very good player. So... those are the 4 guys that I really wanted. So now I'm kind of going to turn it to Twitch chat. You guys can now vote on the new characters, but a couple stipulations. 1, I'm not putting pros on my team. That's just not going to happen for a variety of reasons. I want the main backyard kids. I will pick a custom character if people want, and I will take ideas if people have ideas for custom characters. I also have a couple of ideas, but I ultimately get to decide who the custom character will be. I also will point out that I'm not having Tony on the team. So don't vote for Tony. He's not going on the team no matter what. Otherwise, you guys can have at it. So we go, oh boy. Marty votes for Kimmy, of course. Mello votes for Ricky. And Raid votes for Reese. Wow, those are literally the 3 worst players in the game. Okay, no. They're in the bottom 4, maybe. What's wrong with Tony? Tony has been on my team for the first 3 seasons, and if Tony and Angela are on the same team, they both get stat penalties, so that's not happening. It looks like we've got 3 votes for Reese. Alright. Oh boy, yeah, this is gonna be a tougher season than the last couple.
I can tell that you have an eye for talent.
Alright, we get Reese Worthington. Fair enough. Also, I would ideally like it if we did not have Billie Jean on the team, because if Billie Jean's on the same team as Du Bois, then she gets stat penalties as well. We need more girls. We just need players. Who's the kid who ate the house? Dante Robinson? Marty, you just want me to have the worst team, don't you? So we have 1 vote for Kimmy. We got 1 vote for Ricky. Don't! You guys are literally voting for the worst players. If you were to ask me who the 4 worst players in Backyard Baseball were, I would say Gretchen, Reese, Kimmy, and Ricky. They're all terrible. We have not had Annie Frazier yet. I'd be down for Annie Frazier. She's pretty good. Oh, Kimmy gets a boost on her home field? Okay, all right. I'm getting more sold on it. Can people come to a consensus? Oh, we have a vote for Jorge. I'd be happy to have Jorge back on my team. I was hoping people would be voting for Dimitri, my man, but that's fine. Okay, a vote for Jorge, a vote for Kimmy, a vote for Annie, a vote for Ricky. I think a vote for Dante. The Dobbs siblings just don't exist. Okay, we do have a vote for Dimitri. I'm not putting Luan on my team. Here's the thing. I already have my lead pitcher, and that's Angela. I don't want another character who's only good at pitching, because that's going to really be tough. So how many we have? Oh, we still have 4 slots open. Okay. I had Kenny back in Season 1 when I played the 97 version. I like Kenny. Kenny's a pretty solid player. His batting's not fantastic, but he's pretty good at everything else. Okay, yeah, I'm... If people are down for it, we got 2 or 3 votes for Kenny at this point, so... Yeah, yeah.
Great.
I'll go for Kenny.
Any position.
Nice to have you back, Kenny. We need... Kenny is fairly consistent, if memory serves. He catches pretty much everything that comes his way, which is good. Alright, well... Her name's been thrown around a lot. I'll pick Kimmy.
Hi, my name's Kimmy, and I like candy.
I'll pick Kimmy.
Choice,
look at those stats. Absolutely garbage. Alright, we have 2 spots left. If people want the custom character, we can bring him back. It's not going to be Arthur, though. We'll have custom character. Okay, Now, if people have ideas for the custom character, I'm open to them. No guarantees that I will use them, even if everyone is like, yes, do that. No guarantees. My two main ideas are I could have Charlie Brown, or I could have Harry Potter. Both of those I think would be good. But if people have ideas, all right, people like the idea of Charlie Brown. I don't think Charlie Brown will fit on Harley Brown. Jelly Bean! Can we do Chuck Brown? We can do Chuck Brown. Alright, he's a boy. He froze right-handed. I'm gonna look up Charlie Brown's birthday. I'm sure his birthday has been established. That's the thing. For Charlie Brown, I'm gonna have to make him suck, kind of, because he's not a very good player. His birthday is October 30th. Alright. Oh yeah, I'll definitely be putting in some Charlie Brown sound alerts if we have him as the team. Alright. So, Charlie Brown's at least not awful at pitching. So we can give him like a 5 at pitch. Should I just average him at all stats? Should I just make Charlie Brown like thoroughly mediocre? It was my best birthday ever, Charlie Brown. That's the one worth Linus rollerblading for 3 minutes straight. Alright, yeah. Do people think that that's good? Just giving him the average in every single stat? I think that's a decent idea. Alternatively, I think you don't have to give him stats if you don't want to.
The most exciting thing about winning?
I think we could literally make him one at everything. I'm not doing it, but we could. Alright, that's fair. Alright, here we go. Wait, oh, his nickname. I almost made him Spaz. Spaz, Sparkles, Pickles, Dizzy, Superstar, Ace, Cobra, Lucky, T-Bone, Boom Boom. Alright, to avoid causing issues if people take offense to the word, I'll go Dizzy.
Come on, pick me already.
Alright, Chuck Brown.
I won't let you down.
I couldn't get Charlie Brown to fit on, so it's Chuck Brown. Alright, we are almost 30 minutes into the stream, and we still need to pick our final characters. So, we've had a couple people listed. We've had Ricky listed. We've had Annie listed. I think we had a vote for Dimitri, and a vote for Dante, and a vote for Jorge. So, I guess we've kind of narrowed it down to those four. So, I want to hear, would people prefer Ricky, Annie, Dimitri, Jorge, or Dante? Okay, it's 4 votes for Annie, and given how many people are in my Twitch chat, no one's gonna beat that.
Hey, you. I know you're thinking about picking me, so go ahead. You won't regret it.
Is Annie a good player? Yes. Is she a 9 out of 10 at batting? In no universe. Like, she can get it into the outfield, but I'm not really sure if I've ever seen her hit a home run. Well, here we go, Annie.
Sweet.
And there we go! Here's our team. We got Pablo, Pete, Kenny, Reese, Annie, Angela, Kimmy Ekman, Charlie Brown, and of course, good old Marky DuBois.
My name's Marky DuBois, but you can call me Cootie, because the girls say I got him.
I also gotta say that our team uniforms are way cooler this season than they were last season. Last season they were purple and yellow, and it was hideous. That's why I don't let Twitch chat design my outfits anymore. Annie I think is going to be pretty strong. Honestly, with the exception of Kimmy and Reese, and maybe Charlie Brown, this is actually a pretty solid team. Oh, and Marky. Marky shouldn't do well, but he oftentimes does do well. All right, here we go. That trophy will be ours. So let's look at the schedule. Okay, we play the White Sox first. Cool, first game against the White Sox. Then the Tigers, easy win. Indians, White Sox, Tigers, Indians. Okay, it's the same over. Then Hornets, the Orioles, the Angels, the Rangers, the Wombats, the Melonheads, the Marlins, and the Yankees. Cool. All right. Well, we have our team. We have our, maybe not the dream team, but we've got a team. And I got confidence. We can do well. Now let's go to the roster, and let's start the first game of Season 4. All right, let's see what their stats are like. So, Kenny is good. Angela's good. Mark has got some increases, y'all! He's been waiting to play baseball again. Wow, Marky kind of fast today. All right, Yeehaw! This is gonna be good. Charlie Brown is average as usual. Pete's fine. Reese is fine. Annie's fine. Pablo's fine. And what the heck? Oh my gosh! When you said Kimmy got increases on her home field, you weren't kidding! Dane! She actually might be amazing! Alright. Oh, this is gonna be good. Okay, so we gotta have Markey at first. Markey is amazing at first. Angela definitely is the pitcher. Reese is not gonna be in the outfield. Do we really want, I guess, Pablo in the outfield, but Pete's going to be in center field. Do we really? Yeah, you know, we'll put Kimmy in the outfield. Why the heck not? Reese, you can be at third base. I don't trust Arthur's, I don't trust I saw his face and I said Arthur. I don't trust Charlie Brown to catch stuff. And then, actually, let's see Charlie Brown at home. Let's see him at home. All right, now we got to get the batting order. So obviously Pete starts things off, no question. Reese can be second. He's kind of fast. Then Pablo, then Angela. That's fine. Let's see. Kimmy can kind of be the power hitter at the end. Honestly, that looks pretty all right. Yeah, that should be fine. I like that. This is going to be good. We got two players with big increases. This is going to be fantastic. Let's look at their roster. So, uh-oh. They have Keisha Phillips. Oh, but she's got a couple decreases. She's still kind of scary at batting, but less so. Alright, Keisha, we got Uma Morris, we got, oh no, my nemesis Xena Warrior Princess, she's hit home runs on me so much. We got Timmy Unger, he's good at batting. We got Derek McGattery, not sure why he's not at the pitcher's mound. Ramona, oh my gosh, Ramona Quimby has massive increases as well. Alexis Weiss, she's pretty decent. Frank Thomas, he's the fully grown adult who's apparently allowed in the Little League. He's got increases as well. And Jimi Hendrix. Okay, so we got to watch out for Timmy. We got to watch out for Xena. We got to watch out for Ramona. All right, I think I can... Ramona Quimby, age 8, ready to wreck some stuff. Okay, well, we got to watch out for that. Well, now we know what's heading for us, so let's start our first game of Season 4.
Maniac, Sunny Day here, along with Vinny the Gooch, welcoming you friends of the Feather to another edition of Baseball Madness. Today's matchup is between the Chicago White Sox and the Crazy Bombers.
Why did you say it like that?
Bunch of fans, I expect to see plenty of waves, signs, and stupid-looking hats out of you people. Alright, let's get on with the fun!
Had to have that pregnant pause in there, didn't we? Alright, Chicago White Sox versus the Crazy Bombers. Computer versus R3. Are we ready? Oh heck yeah, I'm ready. At the Ekman Acres, let's do it!
Play ball! The starting pitcher today is Angela Delvecchio. Like her brother Tony, Sugar Pop has a pretty solid spitball. Especially on days ending with Y. This next one's a strike guaranteed.
All right, it's a new hope, and we got Angela Delvecchio on the mound. Angela is one of the best pitchers in the game. She can't throw the heat very well, but her slow ball and her hooks are pretty spectacular. All right, one of these seasons I will eventually get fed up and turn off the chatter, but... All right, right to Annie, Markey. Okay, wow, we're off to a great start. Wow! And see, folks, this is why I think Lisa Crockett is a better pitcher than Angela.
Ramona Bennett steps up to bat. I think
because Lisa can actually field. What a way to start the season with a double, with like a triple dummy. Yeah, Markey, you gotta get on base, boy.
And he grabs it. The throw.
Okay, Reese has... No, Markey, you can't step off base. Markey rocketed over. Darn it! Markey, you gotta stay on first base! Oh, this is not good. I'm actually kinda scared, because Xena can hit bombs. Literal, pun intended. I don't care if it's cheap. We're doing hook low and inside. Never mind! Didn't matter! Xena just gives them free points immediately. This is not a good start. Deary me, no. Okay, my infield doesn't have arms. Well, Okay, I think we're going to be changing up our defense positions already. Is this a good time to reveal that one of my goals for the season is to go undefeated? Oh, great, and now we've got the grown adult. Okay. I know for a fact that at least in the 97 version, Kenny had a good arm. So he's going to be the catcher. And we need him. How is Reese already tired? He's done nothing. He's thrown the ball once. Oh, that's right. He has asthma, so he has no stamina. It is a sad state of affairs when the person on my team with the best arm is Kimmy freaking Ekman. All right, Frank, can you hit it down low? Can you? No, we can't. No, we can't. Come on, get this strikeout, Angela. Yeah, there's my girl. Oh, great, it's Timmy. Timmy's a danger as well. He's a menace to society. Okay, good. Oh, nice one, Reese! Okay! Nice job. Okay, it's Keisha. I'm still a little worried because she's still an 8 at batting, but maybe she won't be getting home runs today. The fact that throwing the ball one time depleted 20% of his energy is a sad state of affairs. I mean, what is he, me? We just got to get out of the inning. If we throw it low down, Keisha can't hit it. You saw her swing. It literally only hit the top half of that box. Can you get the snowball when it's nice down low? No, you can't.
That's a one-way ticket back to the dugout. Bye-bye, Banna.
Good job, AD. Unfortunately, we are 3 runs down in the first inning. Pete, you're going to need to pull out all the stops. Like, you're going to need to pull out all the stops.
Ramona Bennett, you can't second-guess the manager going with this girl. She can throw while blindfolded, standing on one leg and chewing gum. I'm not sure if she can make it in the strike zone or anything, but it's cool anyway.
Oh, Vinny, never change. All right, Pete. This is a good chance to see what kind of an arm their catcher has. Their catcher is Alexis Weiss, who's a 2 at fielding. So
I'm going to hit a touchdown.
Well, actually, you're going to hit a grounder. I want to see if the catch... that's going to be... That was not a strike! That was completely outside the strike zone. Great. It's nice to have backyard baseball back. You got the bat upside down. There you go, Reese.
Okay, this time I'm gonna smack it.
Let's try a line drive. What the? You're using a fireball on Reese Worthington. Really? Oh, great.
A blooper in foul territory.
And Reese just lost 50% of his energy doing that. Come on, Reese. If you get a single, you will surpass my expectations. That's all I ask. Or get beaned. That also works. They fear Reese's power. If you fear Reese's power, that's a problem.
From the stretch and the delivery.
Are you gonna walk Reese Worthington? I'd be cool with that. You can walk Reese Worthington. I'm totally cool with that. Alright! Cool! That's like best case scenario. Just walk over to first base, save all your energy, Reese, because we got the secret weapon up next.
Pablo Sanchez stepped in.
Even though the secret weapon doesn't speak any English, we all know he's a rad dude.
Heck yeah. Alright, Pablo. You've hard carried our team through the last few seasons. It's time for you to do it again. Okay. Right. Oh, no. Nice solid hit. Oh, cool. You knocked that guy unconscious. Reese. That's the problem with Reese. He's fast for, like, one run to the base, and then he's slow. Okay, Angela, you're the rare case of a pitcher who can actually hit bombs.
You guys in the outfield better move back.
Angela can be a monster powerhouse, so here's hoping. Should not have swung at that. All right, Angela, aim for the fences. Okay, nice solid hit. I think they're gonna catch that, but. Yep. That's okay. Everyone gets to go back.
And the runner tag.
Do not trust Reese to have gotten to third base because he is gassed already, and it's time, I believe, for... Oh, Annie! Oh, good. She's actually good at batting. I'll try for a power. I got nothing to lose. Annie, if you can get a home run here, if you can tie up the game with this, then, oh my gosh, you'll instantly become my favorite person on the team. Really?
That little blooper.
You're 9 at batting, you've hit a power, and that's what you give us, Annie? That is not a good start. Oh boy, this is an uphill battle. Oh, but we got the big freeze. That'll help us out. Hendricks is pretty decent. I'm actually okay with Angela's heat not being very good. You generally don't want to throw the heat anyways.
A blooper in foul territory.
Right hook is good. Nice strikeout, AD. All right, Alexis. Ooh, we got a corkscrew that I'll never use. I only use a small handful of the special pitches, like the big freeze and the fireball, because they oftentimes will hit the other ones and then just get the special bats. And that's the last thing I need right now, is for them to get a special bat on top of everything else they have. All right, Angela, don't dive for it. Oh, no. Yeah, the fact that Angela... I love how Angela's like one of the best pitchers in the game, but like, as soon as it goes to fielding mode, she can't throw the ball at all. I've never understood that. I know it's like, oh, but because she can't throw the heat. It's like, well, she can't throw the heat accurately. She can still throw the heat, though. No, because honestly, the AI can even hit the big freeze as well. Nice job, AD. Proud of you. Okay, Marky Dubois. I'm hitting power with Marky. I'm absolutely hitting power with Marky.
Okay, that'll bring up Marky Dubois.
And this, because this one here is going plumb out of here.
That doesn't make sense to me, Marty. Come on, Dubois. On the wow! Right to the right fielder, but I like the energy, Marky. Doggone it! I've missed you, Kenny. Your batting's not great, but you are kind of fast, despite literally being confined to a wheelchair. All right. Yeah, right past them. Oh, shoot. Kenny seems slower in this version than he did in the 97 version. Oh, boy, it's time for Brownie Charles. I don't think power's going to work for Brownie Charles, so... Okay, line drive. He is... Wow, I definitely handicapped myself by making Charlie Brown this bad. This is not good. This is very much not good. No. Marky, get back to first. Oh my gosh. I have a mini heart attack every time she throws to first. Uh-oh. Ramona Quimby, age 8. She don't mess around. Okay, cool. Come on. No, Marky! That's the wrong way! Marky! Stop giving me mini heart attacks, will you? I can't handle it. Okay, cool. I am thinking maybe Reese needs to stop being on for a bit. Marky! Jeez Louise, Marky! Okay, I can't believe Kimmy Ekman is one of my best players right now, but... Kimmy
Ekman, what's the score?
This one's going a mile!
Alright, Kimmy. Aim for the fences of your own backyard. Do it. Really, Kimmy? Yeah, actually, that's exactly how I remember Kimmy being. She hits it straight up. Wow. Wow. Marky just wants to add tension to make the games more interesting to watch. Alright, Pete. We're aiming power now.
what am I supposed to do again?
Yeah, I'm definitely changing up Reese's position after this.
From the windup and the pitch.
Yeah. Oh, that's a foul.
It's going up
no,
the right
don't catch
line,
that. No, don't catch that. Go back, go back, go back, go back, go back. I hate how you can't tell your guys to stay. It's so dumb. Oh, great. Well, this is an instant out. Not only is he terrible at hitting, he is now absolutely drained. Reese is not going to knock it out of the park. I don't think he's physically capable of hitting a home run without an aluminum power bat. Okay, that's right to him.
He's out. Tag first.
How dare you compare Reese to the likes of Pajama Sam? Pajama Sam is way better. Alright, Pablo. We really need a homer. We absolutely need a homer on Pablo. You can do it. I'm not swinging at that.
Ball one. One and oh.
If I had bunted, that probably would have been a double play. I thought that was going to be turn into a slow-mo. No, don't catch. No! Doggone you! Who let the grown adult play in the Little League anyways? This is really bad. Wow, Vinny! Nobody asked you. Oh, wait, hang on. Before anything else, so first off, oh, Reese got most of his energy back. Cool. Let's put him maybe at shortstop or second base. Let's put him at second base. Annie, let's put it third. Okay. Oh, Charlie Brown, catch it!
Good grief.
Not gonna make it. Throws it over to first.
Charlie Brown didn't make it. That's okay, Charlie Brown. Oh no, that might not be okay, Charlie Brown. If Timmy hits a home run, it's kind of over for us. Is that gonna be an infield fly? By baseball definition, that should be an infield fly. I had Marty's boyfriend explain to me the infield fly definition. That should have been an infield fly. Probably dumb, but here we go.
Low and inside, and the count is one and two. This next one's a strike guarantee.
The inaccuracy. Uh-oh, that's not good. Okay, cool. Good strikeout, AD. Very nice.
Stick around for your air freshener. Next contestant, bada-bing, bada-boo. Bye-bye, better.
Do-do-do-do-do, you struck out. Alright, it's Hendricks. Okay, we have a juice box, though, so... Gulp, gulp, drink some water! Cool, cool, cool. Oh wait, everybody's slow, though, so that's actually bad. My gosh, Mark, you boy, with the cannon! Yeehaw! Double play, that's what we needed. Now we get a special baseball bat. Oh yes, this is what we need to turn the tide. Crazy Bunt would be great. Aluminum Power Bat would be great, but I'll take anything. Undergrounder? Also is fine. Undergrounder is also good. Marky is hard carrying our team. I'm not swinging at that. Marky had that big dip at the very beginning, but he's been solid since. Rats. Darn it, Angela! Okay, please. No, that's right to freaking Frank. Oh, but we knocked him unconscious. Run, run, Andy. Run, Annie. No, you gotta run faster. Speaking of running faster, yeehaw! The smart thing would be to hit the line drive, but I want to hit power, because I want to see the Marky Gainer. Marky's gotten a home run in the last two seasons. Let's see if we can get it from episode one of season four. Or we could get walked. If Marky gets walked, I can have Charlie Brown hit the undergrounder, and then hopefully Kimmy Ekman can get us home.
time to pitch.
That's a ball.
That was ball three.
Come on, walk Marky! Walk Marky so he can steal second base.
From the stretch, the pitch.
Dash, walk!
Roll down the first baseline.
They're afraid of Marky. They're like, Marky's the only competent player. Yuck! See what I did there, coach? You did great, Marky. Oh, I forgot. Kenny is actually up next. Okay, hang on. I want to see how good their catcher is at throwing. Because Marky is terrifyingly good.
Here's the motion and the delivery. The right one.
Even I can run faster than that! Okay, their catcher sucks.
They have a runner on second, two out.
Mark goes to your third.
The stretch, pitch on the way.
Yeehaw! Let's run!
Like you gotta have ESP to know where that thing's gonna pop up.
This is big brain time.
Come on, Kenny, don't flub this. That was close, but okay, we got a point. We got a point, and that's good. Maybe we get another undergrounder as well.
A whole season without ever once scoring. They were the worst players in the history of the game. Into second with a standing double. Nice one.
Vinny wasn't even talking about our team. Come on, Charlie Brown. We still have another. Cool.
Think this kid is afraid of anything.
Charlie Brown, you can be the goat. I know in the comic goat was the insult, but Kenny got the first RBI, it's true.
Here's the windup and the delivery.
I'm not swinging at that.
The runner goes.
Okay. I thought Alexis was just always going to barely throw it, but I guess not. Okay, that's fine. Hey, batter, swing batter. I'll swing when it's a strike. Okay, I gotta swing at this. There we go. Run, Kenny. Or, I mean, wheel, Kenny.
It's like you gotta have ESP to know where that thing's gonna pop up.
Ground rule double for Charlie Brown! Charlie Brown's the GOAT. Charlie Brown, how does it feel to be on a good baseball team for once? Even though we are still losing. Kimmy, if you get a home run here, I will buy you all the Twinkies you want.
Nobody else like her.
They have a runner on second, two out. This one's going a mile.
I hope so, Kimmy. We need this home run here. Come on. Okay, Kimmy, you got the energy, but you gotta direct it in the right direction. You want Twinkies? You want Whoopie Pies? Kimmy, I'll give you Whoopie Pies if you get it out of here. Ho-hos. Okay, Kimmy, you got it. You gotta hit it forwards. Oh, Kimmy! There's no way she got the first. No, she didn't. Darn it, that was close, Kimmy. But no Twinkies today. We at least got 2 points. We just need one more to tie it up.
The effort is there, but they just
that was so close, though.
Today. So I remember back in my youth, last year, Bombers had a tremendous season. This kid, Martha Smalley.
Who?
She moved to Pittsburgh last fall. You're too young to remember her, kid.
Vinny, I'm older than you.
Anyway, Smalley pitched 6 straight shutouts. Even Pablo Sanchez couldn't get anything off her. Pablo was playing with the Giants at the time. Anyway, they called her Firearm. I heard she was the great-great-great-granddaughter of Walter Johnson. 6 straight shutouts. Yeah, those were the glory days for the Bombers, I tell ya. Back in the days of Firearm.
Wow.
I know Vinny was kind of insulting my team there, but honestly, the random banter you can get between Vinny and Sonny are one of my favorite parts of the game. It's amazing. Okay, we're still in a bit of a rough spot, but we're now at the... Oh, dang, nice job, Angela. We're now at the strong part of our lineup again, and we just need to get 1 point to tie it, and if we get 2, we get in the lead. So I'm a lot more confident now. A Snarf Blat. Wow. Hey! When Angela did that last inning, it let them catch it. I actually will throw the slow-mo then. Might be my downfall. Nope. Okay, cool. We got her out. That was risky, but... I could use a juice box, though. If I get another special pitch instead of a juice box, I will be in a bit of a bind, because I won't be able to replenish my juice unless I use the special pitches. Jeez, Vinny! Stop being so savage! Alright, Pete. Their catcher's terrible, so we just need you to bunt. We're gonna make you bunt. There we go. Boom ba doom ba doom ba doo ba doo boom. And the runner is safe. Nice job, Pete! And Pete can definitely steal second. Okay.
A bouncing ball. Gotta watch your kneecaps.
Yes, it's so easy to manipulate them. Yes! And now Pablo Sanchez is up! I love being able to manipulate the AI. I don't want to say it balances the game, but the AI make far fewer errors than my team does, so. Oh, yes! Oh, that's... Is that out of there? Please, Pablo, home run? Yes! Yes! No matter how old I get, I don't think I'll ever encounter more epic music than Pablo Sanchez's home run music. It gets me pumped every time. Oh my gosh, we're 2 points up, Pablo! I'm so glad I picked you. Yeah, I did notice that it clinked on the chain fence without actually clinking on the chain fence. All right! Oh, okay, that's actually going to be a single. Okay, no. If she hadn't tripped, I actually might have tried to go to second. I don't know if that's a Twitch highlight, but that's definitely the highlight of the episode. Okay, Annie, you're 0-for-2, but I believe in you. 'Cause I believe we can. Okay, don't catch that. Actually, because he had to dive for it, it's not a double play. If they get a double play, they might turn it around. Oh, yeah! Oh, wow, they got... Okay, they're so afraid of Marky, they have to put an adult on the pitcher mound. Gonk! Come on, Marky, you can do better than that, boy! Oh, no. That's bad. That's...
The Bombers are out in front, up by 2.
The Bombers are annihilating their competition.
That's very bad. Nobody out. They now have a special bat. I don't have a juice box. And they've got their free best batters up. Well, free of their best batters. I will do everything in my power to make sure they don't score, but no promises. At least I don't think they'll be using the special bat if they don't get someone on first. So, Annie. You need to throw that to first. Marky, don't move. Yes! Okay, one out. We just need 2 more outs, and we win.
That's the kind of hitter she is, digging in and determined every time.
That's amazing, Mello. That's absolutely amazing. Okay. Xena.
Get hurt.
That was literally perfectly timed. Xena, get out. That literally could not have been timed better. I don't care. We're gonna be cheap. If Xena makes contact with the ball, it's... Look at that. I'm pretty sure... Because internally, like... The character's stats stop at 10, but internally they can go higher. I'm pretty sure Xena's like a 20 out of 10 at batting. Because, like, if she makes contact with the ball, it's a home run.
Thank Thank you for playing. Stick around for a year's supply of air freshener. Next contestant.
All right, good. See you, Xena. Okay, if we get the adult out, if we get Frank Thomas out, then we win.
Get out.
Xena's bat is 189 in terms of power and contact under the hood. That adds up. Yep. One more out. I know, bat has got to have a great eye. All right, Angela, I know you've been... Okay. Angela, come on. You can. We just need a couple more pitches. I know you're tired. I know you've been pitching the entire game, but you're our best option.
I don't think so.
Because you're a mass... Really, Frank? Then who do you think is the best pitcher? Actually... I'm going to do something a little risky. But they need 2 points to win. Charlie Brown, throw the winning pitch.
Dizzy steps up to the pitcher's mound.
When he's not striking out batters, he's
Charlie Brown, take us home. Yeah, Charlie Brown! He's the goat! Yes! Oh, savage Charlie Brown. Yes!
And the Bombers win the game! 5-3.
What a great bunch of kids. They're gonna be hooting and hollering at the mall tonight.
Live from Ekman Acres, this has been Sunny Day and Vinny the Gooch. See you next time!
Yeah! Oh my gosh, what a nail-biter for a first game. But that was amazing. What a turnaround. Okay, that's a great start. I know I said, oh man, this is not a good start. No, that was a great start. There was drama and tension and redemption. Oh man, what a great first game. Reese was the game-winning run, but somebody else hit it for him. You could have replaced Reese with pretty much anybody else. Okay, so we won, and then I don't know any of these icons, so this doesn't tell me anything. Kimmy's like, I did good today, Coach. Kimmy, you really didn't do anything, but... You know what? I'm proud of you anyways. You almost hit that home run, and it would have been epic. So if we look at the league leaders, Jacinda Smith has the most home runs, alongside Yvonne, Little Davey Reynolds, and Horace Yun. Amir Khan with the most hits, along with Fred Flintstone, Chipper Jones, Sidney Weber? Really? Chipper Jones, Amir, and Sidney with the most double. What the heck? Sidney Weber. You should not be the stacked. Leah Wayne hit a triple. Or hit two. Oh, no, not Ken Griffey Jr. He's terrifying. Ray Tran and Yvonne Carter and Horace Yun with the most runs batted in, followed by Pablo. Runs scored. Wow! Chipper's doing well. How does Sidney Weber have a 1.0 batting average? How? That should not be possible. This is ridiculous. Marky Dubois with the most steals. In what universe would the leaderboard look like that? In what universe does Marky Dubois have the highest amount of steals? This is ridiculous. Honestly, that alone could be the first thumbnail. I don't know. That's hilarious. Angelo with the most strikeouts with 8. Cool. All right, Mark, you have some of the most errors, though. It balances out, but... Oh, hang on, no. So next time we face off against the Tigers. Cool. Cool. Okay, so Bombers and Tigers have both won one. Oh, hey, the Detroit Tigers actually won! Go Tigers! I have absolutely no sports knowledge or, like, bias at all, but because I live in Michigan, I'll say, hey, I can be happy if the Tigers win. Monsters and Rangers beat the Athletics and the Angels. Braves and the Expos beat the Fishes and the Marlins. Reds and the Cubs beat the Wombats and the Brewers. Diamondbacks and Melonheads beat the Rockies and the Padres. Blue Jays and Yankees beat the Orioles and the Hornets. Cool, cool. So, yeah, that's the first game of Backyard Baseball, Season 4. Very exciting first game. We'll be right back.